So, good evening all. I welcome you all after the tea break, and I hope that this will be a very exciting session for all of you. So far in the day, we heard a lot about data, how the data being generated, how the data movements are happening, and how the security is coming in the big picture in terms of really involved in protecting the data. But how to protect the data and what matters for you in terms of data is what I would be talking about. And as we all heard about it in the morning, that already we are going through a digital disruption where we are seeing that a lot of data is being generated and a lot of critical sensitive data, I mean personal identifiable information, which is spread across here and there. It is being stored across here and there within their infrastructure. And hence, it is involving a lot of threat in terms of the data loss, the data theft, the attacks that are also getting sophisticated with the period of time, which is resulting into kind of a violation in terms of the regulatory compliances that are not being met, as well as the threat that really looms over the financial companies or any companies that deals with this data. So, where I want to bring your attention is that there is what we see as a paradigm shift, which we call it like the focus is shifting from securing the network towards securing the data. Since if you all know that with the advent of the smartphones, now the offices have become smart. You can work from anywhere, and this has led to a kind of practice where you can disseminate the data from anywhere, and hence the challenge lies how do you protect or how do you basically account the data that is basically been spread across multiple channels, and what are you doing to basically help to protect that data? So overall, the way we foresee that the security approaches over a period of time are actually changing. And earlier, the way the security has been that you secure your perimeter first, you deploy the firewalls, you deploy the network monitoring tools, and then the move focus is more moving towards the core of it, which is protecting the data. And that is what we call the shift is towards securing the data itself. Definitely, most of you would be aware of these, the recent attacks that basically have the kind of threats that related to data that are emerging, where I will say that it is related to either the extortion for taking the data or the data hostage, you can say. So the recent ones, which I would like to just run through a video on that, which has been the Bank of Montreal and the CIBC, which suffered a data attack in terms of stealing of the personal identifiable information of the customers. And you will see how relevant that is and how we are going to address these kind of threats and this, how we are able to help you to basically contain this kind of threats using the technology. This basically, the video has been the one of the latest incidents that happened day before yesterday, and is very, very significant in terms of making you all understand that data encryption is really the need for the hour to protect the data. No matter what we talk about in terms of strengthening the security posture, using all the latest tools in terms of protecting from the perimeters wise, you have the best of your firewalls, you have the web application firewalls in place, still breaches are inevitable. And that is where we come and say that the best focus for us is to agree that breaches cannot be stopped, and hence you need to accept the breach and you need to secure the breach. And in order to do that, you need to be aware of very fundamental questions that basically are relevant to you, that where is your confidential data, how is this confidential data being used, and how do you safeguard your data from these breaches or unauthorized access. You, each of us, in from the organization stakeholders who are basically the custodians of this customer critical data, need to ponder about these questions. Other than that, obviously, most of the organizations are today facing the growing challenges related with the regulatory compliances that are being enforced upon in terms of helping you to align with the data security and data privacy, as well as that what things that needs to be done to protect the data. So compliances like PCI DSS, which basically helps in protection of your card information data, Finance Act 2017, your Aadhaar Act 2016, basically, which has been passed in terms of securing your Aadhaar numbers, as well as GDPR, which we heard it in the morning, a couple of people who talked about general data protection regulations that European unions have basically got it passed and is effective from 25th of May 2018. Basically, this all throws up that the network security, which you have seen in earlier cases, definitely helps you to give some assurances. But the assurances in terms of the threat that looms from the insider people who can commit any malicious activity, or the people who can basically circumvent your application security from internally, how do you protect, what do you do in terms of overcoming these scenarios? Definitely your zero-day attacks or your any of the latest evolving attacks can surpass any of your established tools that you have basically implemented across your organization, be it your web firewalls, be it your intrusion detection system. There are opportunities still that lies for the basically theft of your data or basically stealing of your data, and basically helps you to land up into multiple of issues. I would like to just focus upon this recent Aadhaar Regulation Act, which basically has been passed and is currently being enforced upon across the organizations that either deal with your enrollment and update, or basically deals with the authentications, or deals with the data security or sharing of Aadhaar numbers. So it is very, very critical for each of the organizations or the members who are out here in this forum to understand that the UIDAI had basically made a mandate in terms of helping you to secure the Aadhaar number. How do you secure the Aadhaar number? They have come up with a circular where they basically mention about tokenizing this Aadhaar number as a reference number, which has to be used internally across the organization as a consumption. And your Aadhaar number will basically be encrypted and will be stored into a dedicated data vault, which is called Aadhaar Data Vault. We are the people who have recently implemented this across a couple of financial organizations and banks. We have been working right now with most of the organizations to help you meet this compliance mandate. In case there is any query that you want, you can meet us after the discussion and we can let you know how to do this. GDPR, as we just heard in the morning, that this is again where European Union has basically prepared a kind of very stringent privacy law to help secure the European citizens' data. Now, most of us may think that this is just related to European citizens. This is not much applicable the way in current scenario for organizations working within India or within the law of land where the jurisdiction may not fall. To just tell you about that, India itself is also constructing their own data privacy framework. I got an opportunity to be part of the discussion that was done in IIT Powai some months back. And this is also something similar in lines the way GDPR law has passed out. GDPR took 4 years within the European Union to basically kind of pass it and regularize it. For us, again, it could be a matter of another 2-3 years where this law would, a similar law would be basically coming in effect. And we, all of us, need to understand and be ready in terms of how we are basically helping to secure the data, customer critical data that matters, especially which falls under these regulatory framework. So with all this, there is a very, very fundamental change to the security paradigm as we know today. So we see that there is a data-centric approach that is being considered now to protect and control your sensitive information. And the concept like privacy by design, this is basically the encryption, which you would have seen in the previous video, which people are also talking about, as well as by default, where you need to process the minimum amount for the sensitive data that we are talking about. These are new steps that one need to ensure in your infrastructure or in your IT infrastructure that currently being managed. And hence, this also brings a very new mindset that I was talking about, where I said that now you cannot say that the breaches cannot happen, all you can say is that how can we accept the breach and how can we secure the breach? And in order to secure the breach, you need to accept the breach, which basically means that now perimeter security alone is no longer enough. You need to protect what matters and where it matters. And that is where data is the new perimeter for you. And then you need to secure the breach, where basically you need to attach security to data and applications where the insider threat is there. So you can also visit the breach live index, which we published, basically give you details of how much kind of attacks or data losses that has happened across. So we have a three-step approach that we are talking about, where we first help you to encrypt the data. And after you do the encryption, you need to basically store and manage the decryption keys. It's in a separate dedicated box that we basically help you. And then you need to have a very regulated control and user access of these keys, which needs to be basically help you to decrypt the data. So we must protect what matters, where it matters, at the edge as well as at its core. And we need to move security beyond the perimeter and basically help you to safeguard the critical data that we are talking about. How we do it, we describe it, it's a three-step approach. And as such, the overall portfolio that we talk about in terms of the key management, because that is the heart of the whole encryption. How do you manage keys from multiple applications? How do you basically help to encrypt the data at rest, the data that is being generated at the applications, the data that is being residing at your file servers, the data that is residing in your IT infrastructure? And after doing all these encryptions, how are you basically doing the lifecycle key management across all? So are you doing enough for your centralized key management? These are basically the solutions that you require to achieve your most of the regulatory compliances that has been mandated. And we are there across the booth to basically talk more detail about you, how we can help you in terms of fulfilling your centralized key management and data encryption in your organization. Please feel free to meet me or my colleagues at the booth after the discussion, and you can hear more in terms of the implementation, how the timeline that it takes. With this, I think I would kind of conclude my presentation, and over to you, Siddharth.